Canada.com. Syrian chemical biological weapons concern Israel. Israel has serious concerns about what will happen to huge stockpiles of chemical and biological weapons in Syria when the Assad regime collapses. The question is when, not if. And the big question is what's going to come the day after. There is a fall predicted. The immediate concern is the huge stockpiles of chemicals and biological weapons, strategic capabilities that are still going into Syria, mainly from Eastern Europe. So they don't know. They've already sent some of them to Hezbollah, but they don't know what was sent there. They don't know how it will be divided between the factions that are inside Syria. So basically, there's pretty much a free-for-all right now on any nut job that wants to take out the planet. You know, if that's not bad enough, then we've got our own nut jobs. Fears of mutant virus escape halt bird flu study. This is from New York. Researchers studying a potentially more lethal airborne version of the bird flu virus have suspended their studies because of concerns the mutant virus they have created could be used as a devastating form of bioterrorism or accidentally escape the lab. Now, this kind of bothers me as bad as the last one I read you, simply because why would they have concerns now that they've already created it? Now they're going to worry about it? And why would they worry about it if there's such big high security and such big appropriate conditions, you know, the things they have to wear, they have to bathe, the oxygen, all of that. It just doesn't make any sense. This is, I don't know, is this a warning? H5N1 acquires mutations that allow it to live in the upper respiratory tract rather than the lower. It can travel via airborne droplets between infected ferrets, which are considered good models of how flu viruses behave in people. The teams in Wisconsin and Erasmus induced as few as 3 mutations that allow the virus to be transmitted through the air between ferrets. It's not known whether the mutant H5N1 can be spread between people in a similar way by coughing or sneezing, since such experiments would be unethical. Since when do these people have any ethics at all? If they had any ethics, they wouldn't even be doing this kind of research. They would not have already created a mutant virus. They wouldn't have already created it if they had any ethics. But this really bothers me that they are now saying that they're scared and that these engineered viruses could escape from the laboratories. That, and they're going to hold off until February when they go over to Geneva to the World Health Organization and have a little chit-chat about how they should proceed on their H5N1 research, the mutant research. I mean, are you kidding me? The people in the United States that are doing this, these scare me far worse than what's going on in the Middle East. So I thought I would look it up on the Global Incident Outbreaks map and see what is going on around the world right now with H5N1. Sorry to blur you out there. There's an awful lot going on in India, Indonesia, and China predominantly. One of the links was to the poultry site, Avian. Avian influenza is caused by a type of influenza virus that is hosted by birds but may infect several species of mammals. It was first identified in Italy in the early 1900s and is now known to exist worldwide. The strain of the H5N1 type of avian influenza virus that emerged in 1997 has been identified as the most likely source of a future influenza pandemic. So if they're saying that this is going to be the likely source of the next influenza pandemic, deadly within a day, I don't know. I don't know. There's something here that we need to pay attention to. Maybe these guys are afraid because maybe they've been told they're gonna get it first. Anyway, the strains of the avian influenza virus may infect various types of animals, including birds, pigs, horses, seals, whales, and humans. However, wild fowl act as natural, asymptomatic carriers, spreading it to more susceptible domestic stocks. Avian influenza virus spreads in the air and in manure, and there is no evidence that the virus can survive in well-cooked meat. So for all you people that have chickens, here's what you need to look for. And then there's a vaccine, there's a biosecurity alert, and then there was a little bit more information about it here. It does talk about how well it can survive. You can't eat the eggs, you can't, none of it. It's moderately resistant and can survive days in freezing cold temperatures, but it is inactivated at a temperature of 56 degrees centigrade in 3 hours and 60 degrees, I don't know what sin is, in 30 minutes. By an acid pH, by oxidizing agent, and by formalin and iodine compounds. It can remain viable for long periods in tissues. So, here's what happens. Same thing, what to look for. So, I wish I had something more positive to discuss today. However, this is a reality of what's going on. Well, as always, be safe and God bless.